Our first question is from Sister Amina from the USA, and she's asking, why is it when a woman wears the proper hijab that she is portrayed as being an extremist?
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه ومصطفاه سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. All praise to Allah, we praise him and we seek his help. Whomsoever Allah guides is a truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, no one can show him guidance. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the Quran, Allah the Almighty recorded a very important fact. He said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَضْحَكُونَ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَزُونَ وَإِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمُ انْقَلَبُوا فَكِهِينَ وَإِذَا رَأَوْهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَضَالُّونَ وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ. The previous verses of Surah Al-Mutaffifin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded exactly the way that the disbelievers, the unbelievers, the criminals mock at and make fun of the believers. They make fun of them whenever they pray. They make fun of them whenever they recite the Quran. They make fun of them whenever they dress modestly. They make fun of them whenever they observe their religious duties. They make fun of them, they mock at them, and they laugh at their performance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ. There will be a day on which the believers will recline on their couches and will be laughing and mocking at the criminals, those who used to mock at them in this life, for being sticking to the religious commitment which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained upon the believers. This is a worldly tradition. Nothing has changed, and it will not change until the Day of Judgment. Similar to what happened to the prophets. We're talking about not you and I, not religious scholars, not righteous people. We're talking about prophets who were supported by miracles from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have been receiving revelations from Allah. Allah would send Jibreel alayhi salam to reveal to them whatever instructions he wanted to convey to mankind. And they belied them. And they said, you know what? You guys are sorcerers. You're magicians. You're soothsayers. And it was very common to say, أنت مجنون.
Subhanallah.
You're crazy. You're insane. Knowing for fact that they are not, none of the above. But this is the traits and the habits of the criminals. So I assure the believers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them the gardens of paradise as a result of their patience. As a result of their patience. يُجْزَوْنَ الْغُرْفَةَ بِمَا صَبَرُوا. By the end of Surah Al-Furqan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about those who endure the religious commitments and practices patiently, they shall be rewarded with heaven as a result of what? As a result of their patience.
SubhanAllah.
Those who will be very weak, and once they are stopped by somebody who would make fun of them, would laugh at them, or threat them, so they quit. Or a woman would take off her hijab. Or. They're very weak believers. They're very weak believers. Once Abdullah ibn Mas'ud learned the Quran from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was a very weak companion. Weak with regards to his physical body structure. But in reality, his iman was kind of the strongest. So he went to Al-Kaaba and he was the first to declare the Quranic verses and he recited them out loud. So Abu Jahl came and he slapped him. And the slap was so extreme to the point that he tore his ear. He came to the Prophet ﷺ and he was crying. So Nabi ﷺ comforted him and he assured him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would take revenge for him. A few years later, on the Battle of Badr, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud sits on the chest of Abu Jahl. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was a shepherd, a very little shepherd, and he was a slave. So he's sitting on his chest, holding him from the head. And Abu Jahl says to him, لَقَدْ ارْتَقَيْتَ مُرْتَقًا صَعْبًا يَا رُوَيْعِيَ الْغَنَمِ. He doesn't even call him a shepherd. He's minimizing his name, that you're not even a complete shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
So Abu Abdullah ibn Mas'ud chopped off his head. And he brought it to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, now you're even. A day will come where the believers would take revenge. A day will come, if not in this life, in the hereafter. فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ ينظرون, reclining on their couches, laughing and looking at them. هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Have you gotten paid properly, your compensation, as a result of mocking at the believers?
SubhanAllah. SubhanAllah.